What's up? So, as you can tell by the title of the video, we're going to talk about 2020. What was it? I mean, there was a lot that went on. I mean, a lot. Protests. I mean, you know, wearing masks. A whole lot of other stuff too. Shootings, murders. We've seen crime rates all over the place go wacky. An election that almost split our country apart, you could say. But I think people are lacking in the fact to notice what was good about 2020. And I mean, as much as there was negative, there's bad, there's a lot of putting people down, there also was opportunity. And a subtle realization is that with that opportunity, you could do whatever you want. Many chose to sit there depressed and took them to their limit. And some just went with the flow. But I want to talk about not just what happened around the world, but about the YouTube platform. And I think on YouTube that gave us kind of a different reality, a different environment to scroll through and move past what was on the outside. And to list a few at least, talking like MCYT, or the Minecraft YouTube community, with people like Tommy Innit, Dream, Sapnap, George Not Found, and the revitalization of Technoblade. They all were able to reconstruct Minecraft, and even though it was kind of plain, they were able to make crazy ideas like Manhunt and Block Swap and stuff like that too, and content really just that we could feed off of and fill that void that was starting to create from lockdown. And they really proved how much potential Minecraft still had at its base. And then we had Mr. Beast. Mr. Beast created things like, I don't even know, just tons of charity, a lot of crazy ideas with, like, one of his recent ones was the Christmas lights, customize the Christmas lights around a house, you win it. And it's just those kind of ideas which eventually presented him the Content Creator of the Year award, kept us enlightened and just in awe about the potential and craziness of money has. And one of his fellow like group members, Carl Jacobs, also got to be a part of that MCYT experience. And then we had the end of Unus Honest in November of 2020, which started back in November of 2019. And they were able to impress us with the whole, project of you only have 1 year and you gotta do whatever you can. And that whole idea kind of changed YouTube forever, because as they said it, I mean, some will probably disagree, there was no one that could do it like them. They were the first to try it. They deleted their entire channel, but they created a concept that left people heartbroken and understanding as well. And we got to enjoy Markiplier through that, and also see a lot of growth from his partner Crank Gameplays. And then we were kind of kept up with, you know, the usual trio of Markiplier, Jacksepticeye, and PewDiePie. All three of them proved to just go on and keep making content that they liked and try to prove there was more to the world. That moment with charity and just compassion that you didn't really get to see all the time. And then we still had the Sidemen, we still had KSI, just goofing off and being comedic so we can just smile every once in a while. And then we had Jake Paul and Logan Paul presenting that they still want some fights, even at the end of 2020 and the beginning of 2021. And believe me, I'm rooting for Conor McGregor. But and we also had Twitter, and Twitter kind of kept us going with a bunch of, you know, funny memes, but also like turmoil for jokes, obviously. And they got gifted with, what else? We got gifted just with growth. And I think we need to take that into account for. So, as 2020 could have sucked, it also could have been good. It's a lot of mix between the two. I'm just here to say, notice what YouTube did for us and appreciate that. That there were still people out there willing to give hope, joy, fill people's lives with that void of not being able to see friends or not being able to breathe properly or having loved ones taken from their life. And while there is a stigma of 2021 just going to be the whole Thanos snap into a change of no problems, we're all fine, 2020's gone. Well, that's not true, obviously. Problems continue, conflict is not over. We're still having turmoil now. But where's that stopped us? I think I'm excited for 2021, and I hope you are as well. And even though I listed some things that might have not included you, there's a lot more to appreciate with friends, family. If you went through anything, gratitude is a key to that moving forward, forgiveness, and hope. And while this is my first video, obviously, I hope to be one of those content creators as well. I want to give you something to giggle at when you're feeling down. And I hope to do the same things those amazing people can do. So just keep your eyes waiting, watching, stay vigilant for what I have to bring to the table. Thank you so much. Enjoy 2021.